Hello, this is Lazarus at telecomTech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the network and broadcast addresses of an IPv4 subnet. Now, before I begin, I'd just like to remind you, please subscribe to my channel if you like my videos. If you like this particular video, please click the thumbs up button. By doing so, you'll help me to be able to get more useful content out there for you. Now, an IP subnet defines a range of IP addresses that belong to the same network segment. Subnets are defined by an IP address along with a subnet mask. For example, let's take a look at this particular network. Now, in this network, we have two devices connected to the 192.168.1.0/24 network. But let's take a closer look. Here we have a host with an IP address of 192.168.1.10. And based on this /24 indication in the network, the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. Now let's look at this IP address and subnet mask in binary. I'll display only the last two octets in binary. The first two will remain in decimal, just to keep the numbers more recognizable. Now remember, wherever we have a 1 in the subnet mask, that bit position in the IP address belongs to the network portion. And here we have the first 24 bits that belong to the network portion of the address. Now all addresses that begin with the same first 24 bits belong to that same subnet. In this manner, we define the range of IP addresses that belong to this subnet. The values where we see X are the values that can change. So any hosts in the whole network segment can be assigned an IP address that begins with the same 24 bits. So the range of addresses that we are provided with are those that have a host portion range from all zeros to all ones. If we translate that to decimal, we have a range from 0 to 255 in that last octet. Now, where do the broadcast and network addresses come in? Let's go back to our binary representation of our address space. Here I've added some more of the subnet range, starting at 0 all the way up to 255. I've also placed the decimal number of the last octet here as well. You can see how these numbers increase sequentially. A network address is defined as the IP address within the subnet that has all of the host bits set to 0. Similarly, the broadcast address is the IP address within the subnet that has all the host bits set to 1. So you can see here that this is the network address, and this here is the broadcast address. These are reserved addresses and cannot be assigned to a network host, such as this laptop, for example, or this PC. If you attempt to assign these addresses, the operating system of your device will typically tell you that the address is invalid. So when you're subnetting, remember that the number of available host addresses will be the total size of the subnet minus those two addresses. So in this particular case, with a subnet mask of /24, we have a total number of usable host addresses of 256 minus 2, which is 254 hosts. So what is the network address used for? Well, it's used primarily to identify the specific network segment from outside of the subnet for routing purposes. Take a look at the wider network of this particular subnet. Let's look at the routing table of our router here. Some information in the routing table is omitted, but what I would like to draw your attention to is the static routing entry here. It states that to get to the 192.168.1.0/24 network, we use a next hop IP address of 192.168.5.1, which is this particular router here. Now, this entry has the network address of our subnet, and that network address represents this whole subnet. So from outside of our subnet, we use the network address to represent the whole set of hosts that belong to the network segment. And that's why we see network addresses in our routing tables. So you can see here that the network address is crucial to allow routing to work. Now, what about the broadcast address? What is that used for? Well, within a network segment, there are various mechanisms that need to be able to reach all hosts within a subnet. Things like ARP and DHCP are services that need to reach all the hosts within a subnet at the same time. To do so, we don't want to send one packet to each of those hosts. We may have tens or hundreds. So what do? We use the broadcast address. Let's say our laptop here wants to send an ARP request to discover the MAC address of a particular device on the network. It'll send the ARP request to the network address, that is to the address 192.168.1.255. By doing so, all hosts on the network segment receive that message. Such broadcasts are always contained within the network segment, and this is the reason why a network segment is considered a broadcast domain. So whenever you're subnetting networks, it's important to keep in mind that you must set aside the network and broadcast addresses as special use addresses. They cannot be assigned to a network host, and knowing that is an important part of the subnetting process. Subnetting is a huge topic, so look out for more of my videos covering the various aspects of subnetting, including how to subnet networks. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click the thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, please feel free to let me know in the comments below. And also subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.